Instead of asking yourself, how much money do I need to start investing? It's important to think about the big picture of where you are financially and what your goals are. We've put together a list of the key boxes to check off before you put your money in the market. Investing is a great way to grow your wealth, but starting to invest when you have high interest debt is counterproductive. It's like taking one step forward and two steps back. An average index fund will see 5-6% returns annually. But on the other hand, credit card debt usually incurs an interest rate of 20% or more. And the thing is, your returns in the market aren't certain. You could gain 5-6% in the market, or you could even lose your money. But one thing that you can control is your debt. So make sure you pay off all high interest debt before you start investing. Whether you're saving in case you lose your job, if you need to take time off work to care for an ailing family member, or your car breaks down and needs repairs, it's always a good idea to have 3-6 months worth of expenses tucked away in a savings account. A savings account is important because it's liquid. You can access your money at any time. If you have your money parked away in an investment account, it'll be difficult to access that money immediately. Although savings accounts can be a great way to earn a little money back, their interest rates usually aren't high enough to outpace the rate of inflation. The average inflation rate is about 2% annually, and investing is a great way to surpass that. Everyone needs to take their financial future seriously, but you probably shouldn't invest all of your extra income. If you're like us, you'll want to travel and buy some new gadgets from time to time. Money for these short-term goals should be stored away in a savings account, because that way they can be easily accessible. Remember, markets will fluctuate. If the amount of money you have to invest is such a critical part of your financial well-being that you can't stomach losing any of it, you might instead consider an investment with a more modest but guaranteed return, like a GIC. When you have enough money saved up to ride out potential market dips, then you can consider the idea of other investments in the future. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe.